Irene. Hi, Irene. How are you?
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, Irene. How are you?
Very well, teacher.
Nice to see you.
Very well. Nice to see you too, teacher. For the moment, I am in the computer, but I will change to the cell phone because my son.
Thank you.
How was your day, teacher?
It was good, actually. It was a good day. I had to teach classes for university today.
University?
Yeah, I teach classes at university and I had classes today.
You are catedratic in the university?
Yeah.
Ah, interesting. I didn't know.
Yeah, I do. I teach classes at university.
That's amazing.
Thank you. So how was that?
Sorry, your husband is bilingual too?
No, he's not. He's not bilingual. My children are, but my husband, no.
Okay. Normally the couple are bilingual now.
Right? Yeah, true, but not in this case. Only me and my children.
Ah, okay. But the children is very necessary, the English.
Yeah. Right, yes, it is.
In my case, to my son, he's like it too.
Oh, really? That's nice.
Yeah.
Do you teach him, Irene, or does he go to like academy to learn English?
Me?
No, your
my son.
Yeah, your son.
My son. Was in the academy, private.
Ah, okay. Okay. Okay.
Only in the college.
Okay, very good.
Uh-huh.
All right, very nice.
Hello, Jesse.
Hello,
Jesse, why are you wearing that today? Why that color?
Because I sincerely with you.
Okay.
I don't click that other color.
Jesse.
Yes, it's because I had a lot of work. Mm-hmm. And then I am a little sick that 3 years ago. Okay. And for today, I have to attend for the Father's. Oh. Yesterday, today, and the next Monday, I have to attend the father all day. Because in the school, I start to attend the father face-to-face.
The parents?
Yes.
Oh, really?
Yes, we have to attend the face-to-face parents because we have to improve the level for students have.
All right.
About the scores.
Right. Okay. Very good. Jesse, how many years have you been teaching at that school?
In that school, I have 10 years.
Oh, really?
Working. Yeah, but before I worked in 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
Before that, I worked in one year in the Espiritu Santo College in San Salvador.
Oh, by in Santa Tecla.
No, in San Jacinto.
Oh, the school. Ah, the school. I thought you said college. College is like the university that you guys have.
Yes, yes, mm-hmm. In the school. Oh. In front of El Zapote.
Yes, I know.
Yes. I worked 2 years in the Santa Clara de Assis College too in Usulután.
Oh my goodness, Jesse. So you've been in San Salvador, San Usulután, San Miguel?
En Santiago de María, en Merliot too, in the college of Merliot. Oh, I lived for years.
Really?
Yes. Wow. I know all the Salvador.
All right. Okay. Very nice. Interesting. Yes. You know, Jesse, I studied at the Espiritu Santo University.
Oh, it's our university.
Yeah, but I studied the, it was like about 10 years ago that the Ministerio de Educación had the other
specialization.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. So I studied there for a year on Saturdays and Sundays.
Wow.
Yeah.
Welcome to to our
your world. Right, yeah.
Because all our students are Franciscanos too.
Yeah.
You are Franciscana.
A little bit. I don't know.
A little bit.
Maybe, Jesse. Yeah. I don't know what I am.
Yeah. Oh, but only 1 year.
Yeah, yeah. So, I studied 1 year, yeah.
I had a lot of students
uh-huh.
that had 10 years ago that they lived at our institution.
Okay.
And actually they are lawyers, they are bachelor's degree. Mm-hmm. And when they see me, one student, and tell me, teacher, wow, you're all time younger.
Very good, Jason.
I am very older. Because when I teach you, I have 18 years old. And today I have more older.
Right, yeah.
But
that's nice.
That's good for me. See the student that I have to prepare inside our institutions.
That's right.
That's very good.
It's really nice, eh?
Yes. Have satisfaction about
you. Yeah, of course. Yes, it's very nice. It's very gratifying. Yes. All right, very good.
Yes.
All right, thank you, Jesse. Very well. All right, Williams, hi. How are you today, Williams?
Hi. On the last Friday.
I know, you're here, Williams. Thank you so much. Very good, Williams. Thank you. All right, Dianita, what happened yesterday, Diana Gabriela Hernandez?
I'm sorry, teacher, I had to work yesterday.
Oh my goodness. All right. Yeah, I was wondering, where's Diana? All right, but so happy you're here with us the very last day. All right, Jose Luis, welcome. How are you?
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening.
Good.
Excellent.
You, how was your day?
It was good, actually. It was good. I was teaching all morning today, but yeah, it was a good day. Yeah.
And after finish this course, and the next week, you're teaching too, or rest?
No, I
think you're going to rest.
No, I have another course. Before your class, I have another class from 5:30 to 7:30. And then in the morning, I teach university classes.
You teach almost all day.
Yep. Right. Yeah.
That's
so I'm always teaching. Yeah. Right. But it's nice because it's different. To teach at university is different than to teach like right now. Yeah.
Yes, it's different.
But it's
in the next week you are going to free from 8 to 10.
From eight to ten, yes. Yeah.
Oh, that is good because you have
good.
The time to rest.
I know. Yeah, it's gonna be weird, eh? But yeah, it's good. After 5 weeks, de repente así como, oh, no tengo que hacer nada de 8 a 10. Oh my God! Yeah, no kidding, eh? Right, very good. Nice. All right, Normita, how are you, Normita?
Hi, teacher. Fine, thank you.
Excellent, nice to see you. ¿Qué pasó? ¿Averiguó la farmacia? No.
No, aquí no hay.
No le creo, Norma.
No hay en Santa Ana. La más cerca es Santa Tecla.
Oh, my God, Normita. Bueno, cuando se da una vuelta por estos rumbos.
Ajá. Ahí
right. Yes, very good. Jenny, hi, Jenny. How are you?
Hi, teacher.
Nice to see you, Jenny. I'm fine. I'm fine. Happy to see you and happy it's Friday.
Yeah.
Yeah, Friday. Tomorrow's
Saturday.
Saturday. Very good. All right. I also have Henrito. Hi, Henry. How are you today?
Hi, teacher. I'm motivated because
excellent.
This mode.
I know, eh? Super. I'm very proud of you too. Very good. All right, Berito, how are you, Berito?
I am fine, teacher. Thank you.
Excellent. All right. Eli, hi, Eli.
Hi, Eli, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening, Eli. Nice to have you in class. And Moises, hi, Moises.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening. Thank you for joining us so early, guys. Wow, amazing. Thank you so much. All right, guys, I'm going to... Oh, I'm coming in. Uh-huh, Oscar. Very good. I was wondering, where is Oscarito? All right, thank you, Oscar. Excellent. Very good. All right, guys, I'm going to take attendance right now so we can begin and we can actually finish this course today. I'm so excited. All right, Nancy Elizabeth Larin Chavez.
Present, teacher.
Excellent. Erika Lirio Perez Diaz. Eric is not in right now. All right, Eric Mauricio Paredes Hernandez. All right, Henry Vladimir Del Cid Tepas. Henrito. Hi, Henry, Henry. Se le fue el audio, Henrito.
Oh. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, there you are. Thank you. All right, Jose Luis Rivera Gutierrez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Moises Eduardo Alas Roque. Thank you. Oscar Bonilla Flores.
Present.
Cruz Yesenia Maldonado Tejada.
Present, teacher.
Excellent. Very good. Diana Gabriela Hernandez Morales.
Present.
Thank you, Diana. Andrea Maria Trabanino Alfaro. Nope. All right. Let me see. Williams Alexander Rodriguez Argueta.
Present.
Excellent. Francisca Irene Lima Hernandez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Guillermo Antonio Amaya Escobar. All right. Jennifer Carolina Costa Bonilla.
Present, teacher.
Gerardo Daniel Gómez Rodríguez. All right. Norma Araceli Rivera Rivera.
Present, teacher.
Elizabeth del Carmen Salguero Romero. All right. Silvia Marisol Villalta Martínez. Okay. Verónica Lizette Soto Serna. What happened to Berito? Si aquí estaba. Berito, Berito, where are you? All right. Nubia Araceli Cortez Amaya. And also Eric Mauricio Paredes ya entró. Thank you, Eric.
Presente.
Excellent. Thank you very much for being with us tonight. All right, guys. So as I said, I'm very happy. Today is Friday. All right. So, and it's the very, very last day of this course, Advanced One. All right. So tonight, guys, we're going to do a couple of things. Okay. So we're talking a little bit about we're finishing up this whole generation gap and these whole stereotypes of generations, and you guys are going to work on your groups doing a task that I will assign. Also, just to finish up with the manual we use, we're going to be talking and wrapping up the fun voice conjunctions, all right, that is on the very last pages of your manual, and also about run-on sentences. We have seen this before, but it's part of the book, all right? So we need to finish that up, all right? So that's what we're going to be working on today at 9 sharp, okay? At 9 o'clock, we're going to do the cuestionario de satisfacción, all right? Así es que a las 9 de la noche, que no se va a ir a la luz nunca, all right? Ni en su casa, ni en la mía, all right? So we do it together, all right? I'm just going to ask you right now, did everybody get the survey? Did you guys get the encuesta de satisfacción? Did you get the link? Yes, yes. Everybody say yes?
Yes.
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 Okay. All right. Very good. Le mandaron dos. All right, una su WhatsApp y una su correo. All right, el, así es, yes, everybody, yes.
Sure, teacher.
Excellent. La del correo tiene información más personal que la del WhatsApp, porque esa es como en la genérica. Adentro del, del correo que le enviaron está el nombre específico de la empresa a la cual, para la cual usted labora, ¿verdad? Porque una cosa es decir, por decirle SEPA, pero la, el nombre legal es, no sé, all right, I don't know it, all right, but you know it, all right, y si no lo sabe, ahí está en su correo. Entonces, ya eso de las 5 a las 9, vaya teniendo ya eso a la mano para poderlo ir llenando a la hora que nos toca hacerlo, all right? All right, guys, so thank you so much for that. Si hay alguien que no ha recibido eso, dígamelo ahorita para poderlo solventar, all right? Recuerde también, y se lo voy a recordar ahorita y se lo voy a recordar a las 9, cuando ya usted le dé enviar, hay que tomar una captura de pantalla con su nombre, ¿verdad? Porque todas las capturas son iguales, solo que necesito saber que diga William Rodríguez, all right? O que diga Norma Araceli Rivera Rivera, all right? Very good. Okay, guys, so with that in mind, we're going to talk about it. Yesterday for Dianita that was not in class, all right, because she was working really, really hard. All right, Diana, so yesterday we talked about how to bridge the gap between generations, all right? We came up with some ideas yesterday. Actually, your classmates, they were really participating and talking about how to bridge, how to join the gap between generations. And we have talked about 3 generations we have at the workplace nowadays, even a 4th one now, the youngest people that are like 19, 20 getting a job right now. But let's say that they are not the majority of people yet. At a workplace, we say, or we have talked about that we have baby boomers, Gen X and Gen Y. Those are like what makes up the workforce of El Salvador, all right? So each generation has its own characteristics, it's on strengths, weaknesses, stereotypes, all right? Now, yesterday we came up with some, the how we can bridge the gap. We had the how we can eliminate the space between generations, all right? Some of your classmates, they mentioned yesterday about respect, respecting one another, all right? Respecting baby boomers, respecting millennials, respecting Gen X, all right? Some other classmates talked about communication. Communicating is really, really important, all right? We also mentioned about knowing the background, the characteristics of everyone, all right, on the workplace, or at least the department that you work for, all right? Maybe, I mean, if there are like Normita's company, for example, there are thousands of people at Norma's company. So not going to be able to communicate with all of them, all right? But at least she has to have very good and close communication and know the people that are closer to her, all right? So that's like important. Another way that we can bridge this gap is by setting the rules and the objectives since the very beginning. So everyone knows that everyone is working towards the same objective, towards the same goal, all right, of the company, as an individual, as a person, as part of the department, a part of the workplace, all right? So, and then we also shared, or I shared with you, some points that they actually related a lot to what you guys talked about or mentioned yesterday, all right? It was just giving like more tips or more ideas on how to bridge the gap. And one of them was not only communication, but the communication channels that we can use, all right? We were saying that you may have baby boomers at work. Maybe they don't like to be texting on a WhatsApp group so much. Maybe they want to hear your voice over the phone. Maybe they want to see Williams coming into the office and saying something to them, all right? Or requesting something from them rather than, can I get a file, all right, on a cold message, all right? Those would be baby boomers. And now millennials or maybe Gen X, they are okay with WhatsApp texts, all right, or just emails, all right? So we have to know how to get to everyone at the workplace, all right? Or at least at your department. So that's what we talked about yesterday, bridging the gap among generations. We're gonna finish that up tonight, okay? So with that in mind, I'm gonna show you this right here. I've been talking a lot, so I feel like my you know, my throat is kind of like giving in on me. All right, guys, just give me a second here. Okay. So here we have. All right, so we have done this yesterday. We talked about common grounds. Remember setting common grounds and everything. We're gonna start with this right now, and then we're gonna finish up with the task I mentioned to you, all right? The generation gap at the workplace. Yesterday, we also discussed that there is a generation gap. It exists, all right? It's there. It's not something that we can hide. It's not something that we can lie. It's not something that we can avoid, and it's not something that we can omit. But it is something that we can bridge, all right? So if we have all those things that, or we take those things into account, it would be easier to bridge the gap between generations, all right? Now, here we have how to avoid run-on sentences, part one. We have talked about run-on sentences. Remember that a run-on sentence is a sentence that runs into another one, all right? And then it makes like a big, long sentence, and it makes no sense, all right? How to bridge, I mean, how to fix this run-on sentences. I don't know if you guys remember how to do it. Can someone tell me? Last, like about a week and a half ago, we talked about how to avoid run-on sentences. Do you remember one of the ways that we can do it by?
Yes, I remember.
Okay, Jesse?
When you had a comma in the sentence, it's followed by one conjunction.
Right.
It's one way. Another way is that you have to change the comma by one period.
Excellent, right. And then you have two sentences, right? That's right, very good. The other class, like about a week and a half ago, we talked about exactly what Jesse's saying, all right? That we can avoid or omit run-on sentences by using a conjunction. Another way is by placing a period and making two sentences from one long sentence, all right? So here now...
The number three?
Yes?
The number three that you can give, but I know that... The number three is replace the comma by one point of comma. I don't know. I don't remember
the name. Semicolon. Yes, the semicolon.
Yeah, the semicolon.
Very yeah. Right. Very good. Excellent, Jesse. You're such a good student, eh? All right. So here we have this way to avoid run-on sentences. All right. Let's see. Normita, can you start reading use a comma before?
Right here. Use a comma before according conjunction.
A coordinating conjunction?
A coordinating conjunction.
Uh-huh.
Conjunction that joins two independent clauses.
All
right. Example, the gap generation put many employees at a disadvantage, comma, but never and experienced employees are supporting each other.
All right, very good. Thank you, Norma. All right, so one of the ways to avoid run-on sentences is to use a comma before a coordinating conjunction. Now, this is just to remind you, what's a coordinating conjunction? Well, a conjunction is a word that joins, all right? Now, coordinating conjunctions, we have these ones that we know them by fun boys, all right? That they made up this name because we use for, and, nor, but, or, yet, so. If you put all of this together, we have fun boys, all right? That's why they came up with this funny name, all right? And they join two clauses, all right? So here we have the example that Norma just read. The gap generation put many employees at a disadvantage, comma, but newer and experienced employees are supporting each other, all right? Now, if we didn't have the comma and the coordinating conjunction, it would be read like this. The gap generation put many employees at a disadvantage. Newer and experienced employees are supporting each other. And you're thinking like, what? All right, that's too long. I don't understand what you were saying, all right? So that's why we need to use a comma and a coordinating conjunction, a proper one, okay? A one that makes sense, okay? A one that can link both ideas in a proper way, all right? When two independent clauses, Jenny, can you keep on reading? When two independent clauses?
Yes, teacher. When two independent clauses are put together without a comma plus a coordinating conjunction, the result is a run-on sentence. Run-on sentence cause or message to be difficult to read by our audience.
Excellent, by our audience, all right? Okay, so when you don't have a comma and when you don't place a coordinating conjunction, then you have, as a result, a run-on sentence, all right? A sentence that is very long, a sentence that misses the message, a sentence that is difficult to understand, all right? So we have the example right here. Oscar, do you mind reading the run-on sentence and the correction, please?
Run-on, I read the research about the generation gap. It is very interesting. That is the run-on sentence. Mm-hmm. And the correction is, I read the research about the generation gap, comma. And it is very interesting.
Very good. All right. So in that way, you join them and the meaning is clear. You convey the idea better. All right. And grammatically speaking is better. All right. Not only that you understand it better, but grammatically speaking is way much better. Okay. Very good. Do you have any questions so far, guys? We have seen this before in a way, but I don't know if you have any questions. Or you're okay. Okay, very good.
Okay.
Thank you. Number six, Diana, do you mind reading number six? Identify.
Identify the run-ons in the following passage. Then use one of the coordinating conjunctions from the box and the appropriate
punctuation
to correct the sentence. Hint, each coordinating conjunction is used once. Compare your answers with a classmate.
Classmate, very good. All right. So here we have, guys, we have a passage, all right? And there are run-on sentences or run-ons, all right? And then you need to correct the sentences and they give you a hint. You have to use each coordinating conjunction only once, all right? So what I want you to do, in case you don't have the book with you, I want you to take a picture of this right now. So you can go to your groups, all right? And work on it, all right? So here we have, there you go. That's the perfect picture. Take a picture in case you don't have it. If you have it, you don't have to take a picture. Remember, fun boys, for and nor, but or yet so. All right, those are the fun boys, all right? So take a picture and I'll send you to your groups. Try to look for the run-on sentence and make the corrections, of course. You're going to write a comma and then the conjunction that it's best, okay? Are we ready? Ready, guys?
Yes. Yes?
Thank you. All right.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Hi, Silvita. Thank you for joining us. Also, I see Elizabeth. All right. Very good. All right. So guys, we're gonna go right now to your groups, work on this exercise. Just let me see something else, hold on. Don't go yet, just give me a second. Hold on, guys. You know what we're going to do? So we finish this up like right now. We're gonna keep on working on the other run-on sentences. It's pretty much the same. It's how to avoid run-on sentences part two. All right, so what I do, I want you to take a picture of this right now. Whoops. If you have the book, you don't have to, okay? Take the picture of this right now. This is another page. Okay, and then I want you to work on this exercise, exercise 9. Again, you have to read the instructions that are up, like above this, and then you work on this, okay? And then it's gonna be time to come back like at 9, so we do the survey, and then we talk about, we go back talking about the generation gap and everything, all right? So this is for you to like notice, this is what we're going to be working last, okay? After the survey, okay? So you have those two things that you're working on right now. At 9 o'clock sharp, we're coming back, okay? So you have like about, let's say half an hour, all right? I'm gonna be coming in and out, yes?
You can put again the second part.
Yes, of course, Jesse. Just give me a second. Here we go. This one, Jess?
Yes. All right. Yes,
that one.
Thank you, teacher.
You're very welcome, all right. Okay, guys, so we're gonna go right now to our groups, okay?
in the material in the page number 29.
Yes.
Let me one 29. That's what 24, 26, 28. In that one.
Mm-hmm, yes.
Uh-huh. And that part said, when two independent clauses are put together without a comma, must a coordinating conjunction. Mm-hmm. I understand that coordinating conjunction are for and nor, but for yet or so. And when we need to read that paragraph and add that the conjunction plus the comma.
Is correct, teacher? But I understand that we are going to use the punctuation. Not we are going to add some for and nor. We are only to use the punctuation, comma or
teacher, can you clarify please?
Uh-huh, what happened? You're supposed to tell me.
I understand.
Uh-huh.
We need to add the conjunction,
right?
Plus the comma.
You need to add the comma and the conjunction, yes.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. It's correct. Okay, Veronica, the both.
Yes. In this case, according to the book, you have to use the comma and the coordinating conjunction that best fits there.
Okay. And always is write first the comma.
Yes.
And then the conjunction.
That's right, yes. Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
For example, in this case, for Miran.
Uh-huh.
One of the most common management challenges involves how to effectively manage, comma, so all keys of all different kinds. People. Mm-hmm.
All right. Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, Vero, for you, the second one.
So managers and employees in general don't like the behavior of younger generation either. Among their employees.
Mm-hmm.
Can be for this one part, because the idea, the first idea is there. Some managers and employees in general don't like the behavior of younger generation leaders.
Yes.
And comma?
No.
Must learn to promote a good environment among their employees. And maybe.
Where are you placing the conjunction, Norma?
After leaders.
Some managers and employees in general don't like the behavior of younger generations. Uh-huh.
And leaders must learn to promote a good environment among their employees.
Right, okay, so after generations, you need a comma, and then mm-hmm. think about the coordinating conjunction that best mm-hmm. fits there.
Mm-hmm.
No, but leaders must learn
to promote.
But this one, I agree, Veronica.
Yes, I agree.
Okay, and another one, Robert Hall explored the greatest difference among companies, employees who are from different generations. Robert Hall explored the greatest difference among companies.
Robert Hall explored the biggest difference.
This one. companies, but employees who are from different. No, or no. And.
Normita, can you tell me please the meaning of the word amount?
Cantidad. Mm.
Like entre, Verito. Entre tanto, among, entre, among uh-huh.
Ah, okay. Mm-hmm. I am related to tu cantidad de algo. No.
No, cuando usted dice I am among many people, está entre mucha gente.
Ah, ok. Explores the greatest difference among companies, comma, and employees who are from different generations.
Mm-hmm.
Can be? I agree you.
In that part, why don't have the same views about
and mm-hmm. after company, the comma.
After company, but
or yet, maybe también is a possible.
Where are you, Normita? Es que I'm trying to. ¿Qué pasa que ya no veo, Normita?
Ah, okay.
Let I'm sorry. No, it's okay, Normita. I'm sorry. Generation Z. Ah, thank you. I see.
Okay.
I think
in this one, Robert Half explored the greatest difference among companies, comma, and employees who are from different generations.
Mm-hmm.
Can be used yet too.
But then that would be like changing the meaning, Norma, if you use yet.
Yes,
because yet is may seem a mean for time. No, or right now.
Mm-hmm. But not in this case, Norma.
Ah, okay.
All right, yet if you use it that way, it would be like an adverb, but right now it's like a conjunction. So you're joining two ideas, all right?
Or?
But in that case, actually on that paragraph, where it says Robert Half explored the greatest differences among company.
Comma?
Company employees, no. There shouldn't be anything there. It's just one whole sentence. Robert had half explored the greatest differences among company employees who are from different generations. So that one, there nothing should be changed there, Norma.
It's okay, the sentence.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Ah, okay.
Mm-hmm.
But no, I felt very longer.
Yeah, that's why I actually... I don't know, Normita. According to the answer of the book, it says that it shouldn't be anything, but Robert Half explored the greatest differences among companies, company employees. No, it's okay because it belongs to the, like, the employees belong to the company. Who, ahí lo divide, Norma, con el who. Who are from different generations. ¿Quiénes son de diferentes generaciones? Los empleados de las empresas.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
No, okay. it seems long, but it's not bad because you're using who there.
Okay.
All right.
The another person.
Generation C and Y don't have the same view about change their meaning.
Hi, Nubia. Hi, Nubia.
Hi, teacher.
How are you, Nubia?
Fine, thank you.
I'm okay. Nubia, la voy a mandar a un grupo y ahí están trabajando los compañeros arreglando unas oraciones, oye.
Ah, bye, sorry. Gracias.
Thank you. All right, there you go, Nubia. Hi, Guillermo. Hi, Guillermo. Guillermo. Hello.
Hello, teacher.
Hi, Guillermo. How are you?
I'm
tired.
Muy, muy tired, teacher. Está lloviendo en Santa Ana, estoy inundado.
Uy, tanto así, Guillermo.
El centro siempre se inunda, que llovió muy fuerte. Ahí va a ver las noticias ahí que están subiendo ahorita.
Ah, de veras.
Sí, se ve. Llovió fuerte un rato.
Pero no toda la tarde, solo un rato en la noche, ¿o cómo?
Un rato en la noche, sí, como de las 7 hasta las ahorita 8:10 más o menos.
Ajá.
Cuarto.
Sí. ¿Y se vive en el propio Santa Ana, Guillermo?
Sí.
Mm.
Pero
nice.
Donde trabajo es en un cantón que allá estaba lloviendo cuando salí.
Ok.
Entonces nos toca esperarnos que pase la lluvia porque pasamos dos rillitos.
Uy, sí. Ajá.
Entonces ya, yo queriendo venirme más rápido. Fue más complicado.
Sí, claro. Where do you work, Guillermo?
En nuestros pequeños hermanos. Es una foundation orphan.
Oh, really?
Yes.
That's nice. That's very nice. Are there like little kids or not so little?
Adolescentes, okay. Jóvenes y pocos niños.
Mm. Nice, Guillermo. I like that thing. It's very interesting.
Yes, I have 16 years.
Working there.
Yes.
Wow, Guillermo. And what do you do? Like, what does the foundation, like, what does it do?
It's the raíz, ¿cómo se dice?
The root?
What do you say? The roots is Mexico.
Ah, okay.
Mexico have a 65 years.
Wow, really?
Yes.
All right. Here,
in June.
Uh-huh.
Celebrate 21 years.
Oh, wow. 21 years in El Salvador.
Yes.
All right. And you have been working for 16 years.
Yes.
Wow. Almost since the beginning, Guillermo. Casi.
Más o menos.
Yeah.
5 años diferentes.
Yeah, of course. Very good.
But this is very, very, very different work.
Right, yes, I imagine. Yeah.
In my area is a all coordinator. Check all infrastructure.
All right.
Activities for the boys and girls.
Okay.
Como una forma de vivir, como un hogar, pero grande.
Mm-hmm. Are there many, many kids? Like, are there many teenagers?
¿Cuántos tenemos? Uh-huh.
110. Okay.
Yes, and a Monday.
Mm-hmm.
Receive five kids. Mm. New five kids.
But no babies.
No, the minor or menor?
The minor, yes, the youngest.
The minor, the younger, 4 years.
Oh, really? Now, these children are not for adoption?
No.
Okay.
In the foundation, no adoption.
Okay.
And our work is all education, high school.
Okay.
If they decide continues the education, the foundation
helps
give the university.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Very interesting.
Yes.
Wow, Guillermo, I like your job.
thank you, teacher. Similar in aldeas infantiles.
Yes, yes, I see. Mm-hmm. Very similar.
In El Salvador, I think the two big foundation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see. Wow. Very nice. Interesting. All right. Ok, Guillermo, voy a llamar a los compañeros porque tenemos que hacer la encuesta.
Ok, teacher. Sorry por no estar puntual.
No, that's ok, Guillermo, but thank you for being here. Thank you so much for being here.
Teacher.
Hi, hello.
How are you, teacher?
And how are you, Eli?
Teacher, I have a question.
What's your question, Elisa?
How can I send my information? About my email or WhatsApp?
Which information? WhatsApp. WhatsApp.
WhatsApp.
Yeah. All right. Okay, thank you guys. Yeah, I'm gonna take attendance right now, guys, and then we do the encuesta. All right, Nancy Elizabeth Larin Chavez.
Present, teacher.
Erika Lirio Perez Diaz.
Present.
Thank you, Eric. Wow, thank you so much for being in class. Eric Mauricio Paredes Hernandez.
Present.
Thank you. Henry Vladimir del Citepas.
Presente.
José Luis Rivera Gutiérrez.
No me ha.
José Luis. Thank you. Moisés Armando Alas Roque.
Present.
Thank you. Oscar Armando Bonilla Flores. Oscar. Oscar. Thank you. Cruz Yesenia Maldonado Tejada.
Present.
Diana Gabriela Hernández Morales.
Present.
Andrea María.
Le dice archivo.
Andrea, I'm like, what?
Perdón.
Andrea María Trabanino Alfaro. All right. Williams Alexander Rodríguez Argueta.
Present.
Thank you. Francisca Irene Lima Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Guillermo Antonio Amaya Escobar.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Jennifer Carolina Costa Bonilla.
Present, teacher.
Gerardo Daniel Gómez Rodríguez.
Present.
Norma Rivera.
Present, teacher.
Elizabeth del Carmen Salguero Romero.
Me. Present.
Silvia Marisol Villalta Martínez.
Present.
Verónica Lizeth Soto Serna.
Present, teacher.
Anubia Araceli Cortés Amaya. Wow, guys. Solo nos faltó Andrea María. We were like complete. Oh no, Andreita, what happened, Andrea? All right, guys, hágame un favor para empezar. Los micrófonos, si los pueden apagar, solo para, por la cuestión de los números y todo eso, que no vayan a fallarnos ahí. All right, guys, necesito que le den clic al link que le mandaron de su encuesta de satisfacción. Ahora vamos a ir así de la manito para que no se nos...
La del correo, Ticha.
Sí, sí, porque esa es la suya. Ahora, ahí está.
Ticha, no me abre. No me abre el link.
Intente del WhatsApp. O sea, la larga las dos es la misma, ¿verdad? No está nada lleno, entonces puede ser...
Me lo voy a mandar a otro WhatsApp.
Vaya, ok.
Sí, porque no me abre aquí.
Ok, very good. Los demás, solo si me apaga el micrófono, Maggie, porfa. Thank you. All right. Los demás ya lo abrieron, ya abrieron el link, ya les abrió la encuesta. Súper, gracias, Eric. Normita, ¿ya? Ya, yeah, very good. Vero, sí, Henry.
A mí no me abre tu
chat. Excellent.
No me abre tu chat.
Está intentando, gracias, Guillermo, gracias, William. Cabal, póngame su dedito así, para no estarle preguntando uno por uno. Excelente, el emoji thing. Verito, en el WhatsApp tampoco. ¿Ninguno de las dos le abre?
Teacher,
I am trying to open in my WhatsApp.
Okay, very good.
But a ver, it doesn't work.
Nubia ya lo logró abrir. Eric Díaz ya la envió, ¿verdad, Eric? Usted la llamó la vez pasada. Ah, super, no la vuelva a hacer. Solo es una vez, Eric. Thank you.
I did it too yesterday.
Ah, okay. All right. Okay. So you don't have... No, that's okay. You don't have to do it again. If you did it already, you don't have to do it again.
But I don't catch the screen.
Ay, Eric Mauricio, lo voy a agarrar de la orejita, así ve. All right, that's okay. Nancy Elizabeth, ya lo logró abrir, todos los demás sí, ¿verdad?
Yes, teacher.
Thank you. Silvita, Gerardo, Moisés, Nubia, Irene,
wait
yes.
Wait for me, sí, my computer is, my internet is slow.
Okay, no se preocupe, yo voy a esperarlo todo el tiempo. Slow. No se preocupe.
This is slowish internet, stand by.
Okay, I'm here. Verito, regáleme cómo va. No le abre. Eli.
No, teacher.
Teacher.
Hola, Elizabeth, dígame.
I changed the message a other cell phone. Uh-huh. Another cell phone, it is okay. But then my cell phone, okay. The first name, second name, last name.
Solo, sí. Si gusta, Elizabeth, ahorita solo téngala abierta y lo vamos llenando. Solo vamos a esperar a Oscar que cargue la compu y a Verito. Verito, no le abre. Ni en el correo tampoco, Vero.
I'm going to try to open in my email, but okay. Probably it's... I'm going to type a lot of time.
¿Y si se la volvemos a reenviar?
Yes, to present the survey.
Si se puede volver a enviar, sería bueno.
O sea, alguien que se la envíe a Verónica.
El grupo.
A WhatsApp, al grupo.
I sent for the WhatsApp group, teacher.
Right now, today.
Yes.
Mire ahí, Vero. En el que Norma,
the email couldn't send because it's personality.
Yeah, I know, it's personal, right, you're right, okay. Thank you, Gerardo.
Pues no voy a poder desde otro teléfono, porque no, se ve mi correo.
No, pero los datos son lo importante, Elizabeth. All right, Vero.
Yes.
Ya pudo, Verito.
Yes, because William sent the...
Ah, thank you. All right, very good. Oscar, ¿cómo va?
Okay, I got it now. It's the encuesta.
Yeah, that's right. Very good. Okay, veamos entonces. Ya les abrió a todos, ¿verdad? ¿Ya les abrió? Yes? All right, very good. Okay. La primera pregunta es, ingrese el número completo de la orden de inicio con guiones y pleca. Será proporcionado por proveedor, puede copiar y pegarlo. Igual se los voy a dictar, all right, y cópielo tal cual está, ¿verdad? Es 266.
Ah, orden de inicio, ¿verdad?
Sí, orden de inicio, la primera pregunta.
Ok, I got it now.
266-87-5930-052-PLECA-2020. Got it, guys?
Teacher.
Hola, Elizabeth. Ya lo repito. Dígame, Elizabeth.
Teacher, ya entré, pero me sale un cuadro donde dice inscripción a la reunión. Esto me sale.
No veo, Elizabeth.
Sorry,
no es ese.
No es ese.
No.
Es que es súper entrenado la de Zoom.
Espera,
quiero ver. All right, a ver, vuelvo a repetir la orden de inicio porque alguien me la pidió otra vez. 26, su micrófono, Eli, hágame el favor. 26-687-5930-0052-PLECA-2020. Ok. La segunda pregunta es su nombre, el nombre completo, el nombre tal cual fue inscrito al curso, ¿verdad? Eso también está en la información del correo que le mandaron, porque de repente si es casada y no se puso el nombre de casada, pero usted así lo mandó, lo tiene que escribir tal cual la registraron o lo registraron al curso, su nombre completo. Número 3, correo electrónico, igual con el correo que usted fue inscrito al curso. Si usted tiene otro correo, no lo ponga, póngalo con el cual fue inscrito al curso, ¿ok? El número de celular, ese sería el número 4. Igual el número con el que usted fue inscrito, ¿verdad? De repente a veces tenemos hasta 5 números. Pero tiene que escribir con el cual fue usted inscrito al curso, con todos los que le queman todos sus papeles, all right? A ver, la número 5, ¿vamos ahí? ¿Estamos bien con la número 5?
Yes.
All right, número 5, dice sexo femenino o masculino, ¿verdad? Ahí no hay más opción. Very nice. Número 6, empresa donde trabaja, esa información, si usted se sabe el nombre completo legal de su empresa, escríbalo. Si tiene duda, en el correo personalizado, ahí aparece el nombre completo de su lugar de trabajo. Ok, ahí cópielo del correo y lo pone o lo escribe desde ahí. ¿Ok? ¿Vamos bien? La número 7, nombre del proveedor con el que se capacitó. Ahí puede desplegar, le despliega ciertos nombres. El de nosotros es Inglés Corporativo, entre paréntesis, Regal International, SADCB. All right, esa es, este es el proveedor, ¿verdad? Inglés Corporativo, Regal International, SADCB. Luego vamos con nombre del curso. Inglés Avanzado Módulo 1. Tal cual así lo tiene que escribir. Inglés Avanzado Módulo 1. All right. De ahí nos pasamos a valorar los siguientes aspectos relativos al curso. Léalos ahí, ¿verdad? Dice cómo considera el tiempo para estudiar el curso. Insuficiente, deficiente, aceptable, bueno, excelente. All right. ¿Qué opina del contenido y estructura del curso? Usted puede comentar ahí. Igual que qué opina de las opciones y herramientas tecnológicas utilizadas en el curso. Vamos ahí todos en la 9, terminando la 9, ¿sí? Excellent, Williams, thank you. A ver, la número 10, ¿en qué fecha inició el curso? Este curso inició el 27 de julio del 2020. Esa es la fecha de inicio, 27 de 2020. Fecha de finalización del mismo, ahora que sería el 04/09/2020, el 4 de septiembre de 2020.
La fecha que inicia.
La fecha necesita, Elizabeth, la fecha de inicio es el 27. Del 07 del 2020, 27 de julio.
Thank you.
Y la fecha de finalización sería este día, 04 de septiembre del 09 del 2020. All right. Luego está la 12, ¿cuál es el nivel de satisfacción después de completar el curso? Luego tenemos la número 13, mencione que otros cursos son de su interés. Ese campo, por ejemplo, no es obligatorio, ¿verdad? Usted lo puede dejar o puede completar con algún curso que sea de su interés. Y luego la 14, comentarios, si usted puede escribir su respuesta ahí. Esa, entiendo, es la última pregunta, ¿es así? Yeah, all right. Luego está enviar, démele enviar y luego tome la captura de pantalla que usted lo envió, lo manda, lo puede mandar al WhatsApp de nosotros, ¿verdad? Al que usamos en el grupo o al otro número que le proporcionaron dentro del correo y tómele la captura y escriba su nombre abajo para saber que usted fue el que la llenó. ¿Ok? ¿Alguna pregunta hasta ahorita o algo que quiera o alguna información que quiera que le repita? Estamos bien, ya la mandaron. Si la mandan al grupo de WhatsApp, yo voy
a enviar. Al WhatsApp lo vamos a enviar, teacher.
Sí, lo puede mandar al WhatsApp de nosotros, al grupo de WhatsApp o al teléfono que le proporcionaron ahí, el 7488-6239 también. Igual la captura y su nombre abajo, pero si gusta, en el del de, grupo de nosotros.
Bye. Nombre del curso, teacher, avanzado 1.
Ahorita le digo el nombre completo, Elizabeth, es inglés avanzado módulo 1, sí. Nomás le dan enviar, me regalan la captura de pantalla y la mandan con su nombre abajo para saber de quién era. Very good. Aquí estamos ya. Aquí tengo a Williams, a Henry. All right. A José Luis. Muy bien. Oscar. Cruz. Yesenia. Very good. Y los demás van a ir llegando uno por uno. Very good. Silvita, gracias. Very good.
Creo que ya me fue el internet.
Guillermo, recupérela. Gracias, Norma. Jennifer, igual, thank you. Gracias, Eli. Guillermo, ¿la logró mandar, Guillermo? A ver, todos y todas ya la mandaron, ya la llenaron.
Ya casi te dice, ya la mandan.
Ah, ok, Guillermo, gracias. Diana, ¿ya? Gracias, Diana, very good. Irene, ¿la logró mandar, Irene?
Yes, teacher.
Thank you.
Thank you, too.
Nubia, ¿la logró mandar, Nubia? Elizabeth, ah, ok, gracias, Nubia. Ah, ok. Elizabeth, ¿cómo va? ¿La logró terminar ya?
Yes, teacher, I finished. But right. The other cell phone, because that's my cell phone.
The other it didn't work, it didn't open. All right. So, escribió su nombre, ¿verdad, Elizabeth?
Oh, yes.
Ay, Elizabeth.
¿Le va a dar algo, teacher?
Sí, le va a dar.
No.
Ok, very good. All right, guys, so I think everybody's finished. ¿Ya todos terminaron? Moisés, okay, Berito, yeah. Elizabeth Salguero, very good. Excellent. Thank you, guys. All right, okay, so we're gonna continue with what we were talking about. All right, were you guys able to finish both exercises? Were you able to finish both exercises?
No teacher, only one.
All right,
okay.
No teacher, only one.
All right,
this,
so
this was really difficult. Only one.
I know. Very good. All right, so I'm gonna send you to your groups right now. And you know what? We're gonna go back to your groups, and then I'm gonna call you back. We check them, and then we'll do the last task. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you. Guillermo, lo voy a agregar a un grupo, oye.
Ok, teacher, sí, thank la computadora you. Me trabó.
Sí, ahorita no voy. Se preocupe, yeah, tranquilo. Very good, thank you.
semicolon, la number three. The generation are catching up in terms of basic capabilities. Period. They exhibit different interests and emphasis.
Period.
Period. Period. Then number five, people perceive each other differently than they really are economic. They really are. Period. De ahí capital letter. Economic consequences include millennials quitting because they feel misunderstood.
People perceive.
Semicolon. For me, it's a semicolon.
Just because it's this.
And then the last one is millennials are supposed to, supposedly tech savvy. Baby boomers are loyal to their employers. Okay, that is period. That is
period.
Millennials are supposedly tech savvy. Period. Baby boomers are loyal to their employers. Okay. Wow, this is
the number four. After the basic capacity, you put a period.
Let me see. The generations are catching up in terms of basic capabilities. Period. Capabilities, period. And the other statement is they exhibit different interests and emphasis. You know, this topic is kind of high. I mean, it's hard to understand because you are thinking. I'm tired. I'm damn tired. So what do you think? Can we go back and let's try again. I'm gonna read again for any end times. I mean I will read it again and I will try to do something in them. Okay, that is the
Oscar,
page.
Why are you so tired?
Because
it's Friday.
It's Friday, but these exercises are really difficult.
They are. They make your brain tired.
Yeah, because the hint says that we use any conjunction. Once.
Right.
Once, but I couldn't. I mean,
really?
I couldn't use them all. So let's see, because we will see.
All right, very good.
And we were kind of, you can use, I believe you can use what is the name? Conjunctions. The coordinating conjunction. We can use we have maybe two options in it.
Some of them, you can have more than one option. All right,
this topic was good actually. How do you say temática? It's like this topic. This topic is, I mean, was good. We could be talking about it. This course has finished.
Right.
And we could go on and talk
about it.
But it's not only, but it's not only for practicing English, but also the topic is useful in our companies.
That's right, yeah. I think it's nice that, I mean, yeah, because we relate to them, all right? So it's nothing that we cannot, that we have no idea about, because we do.
And we can use every day.
Right, that's right.
In the workplaces every day.
Yeah, I think it helps you be like more aware of what's going on. Sometimes we just take things for granted, or we just feel that they are normal, you know, and we don't really know why. We just know that's the way it is. But once we like read about it, or we stop to think about it, then we realize that, you know, this is what's actually going on.
Not so many companies are managing this generational gaps. They are just working, but I believe is if they have the clear objectives and clear rules, the rules are inspired in tolerance, respect, and then they will succeed on that.
That's right, yeah. So it's actually interesting. I used to work before this quarantine and everything. I used to work at where Gerardo works. I mean, I used to go there Saturdays to teach English to a group of girls, a group of ladies. Okay. But what I really liked about the group is that I actually had maybe not baby boomers, but some of the ladies were like older. All right. Like I had the youngest girl was 19. And the oldest lady, maybe about 50. All right. Okay. So most of them were between 19 and 27, maybe. And then you jump to Greece and then to the oldest lady. All right. But it was nice because all of them were there because they all wanted to learn English. All right. Okay. And at the beginning, you know, it's a challenge because you stereotype and you say, oh, no, the older lady. She's not going to learn anything, you know.
Okay.
But to my surprise, she was one of the best because she was like, she wanted to learn something, you know, and she didn't want to fall behind the young girls. Mm-hmm. All right. So she was studying every, like, it was only once a week, every Saturday, but I knew that she studied during the whole week.
She went prepared to every
class.
She
was like, really prepared and everything. I really enjoy that Intradesa group. I think it's been one of like the best groups ever because you feel that you're actually doing something for these people, you know? And they are really there and they are very motivated and they want to learn. So I really miss those girls.
Wow. So you have a like a millennials and X generation,
right? Yeah, and yeah, the newest one because there are some girls that were 19, 20.
I knew it.
Yes, Gerardo.
I have the picture.
I know
the picture with the team.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, because I
and really the picture the. Her face is happy.
Yeah. Yeah.
See, I like this course.
Yeah.
Because I'm practicing my speaking skills.
Right.
And some things this is like math. If you don't practice,
right,
you forget.
You forget it.
It's kind of sometimes I feel guilty, lazy. Guilty, lazy. But I'm trying to improve what I have forgotten because I used to have to have more accuracy. My accuracy in my writing and speaking.
All right. Okay. Yeah, but that's what you say. You know, if you don't practice it, you lose it. Especially if you like, I mean, but you do practice it at work, Oscar.
We have a set of English, I mean, a set of words that is called the phraseology. Mm-hmm. We have dialogues. We construct dialogues based on that phraseology.
Okay.
It's a set of words and expressions.
Okay.
So we are squared on that. See, the problem is when you have an emergency or a pilot wants anything that is not related to the service.
Oh my goodness.
They start to speak like, hey guys, I want to, what can I do if I want to go to buy some cigarettes, or how can I go out and buy some pupusas and all the stuff? And then you have to go.
Right, yeah.
English. Otherwise, we are just like, how to say, we have that set of words.
Right.
Of words and expressions. This is interesting.
All right, yeah, no kidding. Sounds interesting. Mm-hmm. All right, cool.
Yeah, it is, but okay, I'm glad to be here, and I think you have helped me to ease my job.
Yeah, no kidding,
To release my jaws.
To release them, right, yeah, to unloosen them. Very, very good. All right. Okay, we're going to go back right now because the last assignment together because of the time and everything, okay? So we're going back right now, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, Gerardo. All right, guys, I've heard some comments that the exercise was a little bit difficult, right? Because you gotta be reading and you gotta be thinking and applying some things. And maybe you had more choices than just using the conjunctions once, all right? Some of them are very alike and then you're wondering, so what do I do here, right? But that's the challenge, all right? So what I'm gonna do right now, because I really wanna finish up the last task, I'm going to share with you the answers according to the book, all right, and see if you guys got it right or what you got right or not, all right? So I'm going to show you here, and then we are going to work on the very last assignment before we say goodbye. Oh, my goodness. Just give me a second here. It's this one. All right, hold on. It's here. Okay. Oh no, what did I do? Hold on, guys, let me just close some things because I have many things open here. All right, okay, here we go. So here, I'm just going to read it to you, and then you see on bold the conjunctions that they wanted you to use, all right? I'm not saying that this is the only way. I'm saying this is the way the book has it, all right? So perhaps you used another conjunction or you placed it in another place, but according to this, this is where it should be, all right? It says one of the most common management challenges in how to effectively manage all kinds of different people. So managers and employees in general don't like the behavior of younger generations, comma, yet leaders must learn to promote a good environment among their employees, all right? I don't know if you had another conjunction that you used there.
No offense, but.
Or so.
But, oh, okay, all right. Where? All right, but leaders must learn to promote a good environment among their employees, all right? That could be another choice. Robert Half explored the greatest differences among companies' employees who are from different generations, all right? In that one, you don't really need anything else because they're already using who, and that's linking everything, all right? For the next one, it says Generation Z and why don't have the same views about change, nor their millennial counterpart, all right? Generation Y often view change more favorably.
Favorably.
Yeah, mm-hmm. For change results in opportunities. Gen Z is accustomed to change, so it is only natural for them to expect it. The research examined employee development related methods, and it found that boomers and Gen X like to learn via traditional courses or self-learning tools. Yeah, we're still like on the traditional courses, not the millennials, or now that the newest generation, they're going to be used to getting the online courses all the time, all right? And it found out that boomers and Gen X learn via traditional courses or self-learning tools, but millennials prefer collaborative technology-centric vehicles, exactly what would be expected given the current relationship with technology or the value placed on personal coaching. All right, so here, if you notice, they are using yet, nor, for, so, and, but, or. All right, now, as a piece of advice, guys, I mean, yeah, we're finishing the course and everything, but I do invite you, all of you actually, to keep on practicing your English, all right? If you want, there's a lot of information on the web about fanboys, about what exactly each conjunction might mean, all right? Or how you may use it better, all right? So that would be very nice for you to like look at. The other exercise, it says the mindset is to make the person your partner, period. Involve them in everything they do, all right? For number two, you're supposed to use a semicolon. Companies will need to embrace radical changes in recruitment, semicolon. A corporate culture will actively demonstrate respect and inclusion for its multi-generational workforce. That would be for number two. For number three, we've replaced a real understanding of the individuals in any given generation with false assumptions about entire generations. This can be particularly destructive in the workplace. All right, so there you have a period, and then you begin the new sentence with a capital letter. The generations are catching up in terms of basic capabilities, semicolon. They exhibit different interests and emphases. Number five, people perceive each other differently than they really are. Economic consequences, millennials quitting because they feel misunderstood. And number six, millennials are supposedly tech savvy, semicolon. Baby boomers are loyal to their employees. All right, so this, as I said before, this is what the book has, all right? I know, for example, Oscar and Gerardo, they used a period right on the very last sentence, right? Millennials are supposedly tech savvy, period. Baby boomers are loyal to their employees, all right? So you may have different things. I just want to show you this so you guys remember what a semicolon is supposed to do. And it says right here, all right? A semicolon is most commonly used to link in a single sentence, two independent clauses that are closely related in thought. All right, that's why a period shouldn't work as well, because a period stops an idea and begins the next one. All right, while semicolon, it relates the two or links the two ideas or the two sentences, and they relate in thought. When a semicolon is used to join two or more ideas or parts in a sentence, those ideas are then given equal position or rank, all right? None of them is better than the other one. None of them is more important than the other one, all right? That's when we use a semicolon, all right? Before we go, guys, and I know we're anxious to leave, hold on, all right? I just wanna show you this, and we're not gonna go back to our groups. We're actually gonna stay here so we can talk about it. Whoops, this is not it, it's this one, hold on. I'm gonna stop sharing here and then I'm gonna share back. It's this right here. All right, so as of the very last topic for the last very 10 minutes, all right, the generation gap at the workplace, I want you to talk about, let's talk about this multi-generational workforce, all right? Think about all the people that you work with at your company or at your department. What are the set of values in general, all right? What are the life's perspectives, all right, for everyone that you work closely with, all right? What is the perspective about time, the productivity and efficiency, all right? So I want you to work on this chart, but before we do that, it says create a comparative chart of the assets the Generation Y and the Generation X bring to the workplace. How do the characteristics, loyalty, flexibility, technological skills, purpose-oriented, etc. of each generation help boost companies' profitability? Organize a brief presentation. We're not gonna do the presentation, but I want you to work on this. Think about the set of values that you have as a company or department. Think about the life perspectives. Think about the productivity and efficiency, all right? And think about the perspective about time. Take into account the three generations that you might be working with, all right? The one that you belong to and the other two. So when we talk about values, guys, what are the values in general of the workplaces that you work for? No matter, I mean, not like taking... I mean, don't focus on, okay, what millennials' values, I mean, what are the millennials' values? Think about the values in general, taking into account everybody that works in the company. Mm-hmm. So what values? Honesty. Yes, Oscar?
Honesty,
all right.
Mm-hmm. That will so be no matter, for the company. Yeah.
All right, so no matter what generation you belong to, honesty, all right, should be one of the core values. When I say core values, are the principal values, the main values, right? Another one?
Responsibility.
Yes, of course, responsibility, all right? It doesn't matter. Loyalty. It doesn't matter if you're a baby boomer, if you're a Gen X, Gen Y. Loyalty, all right, responsibility, all right, respect. What else?
Integrity.
Wow, integrity, yes. All right.
Commitment.
All right. Okay. Those are values. Yes, very good. Punctuality. All right. Okay. Yeah. What else?
Communication.
Excellent. All right. Communication. Right. What else?
Feelings.
All right, so to be like cooperate with each other, like teamwork kind of thing, what else?
Making funny.
Sorry, Normita?
Making funny.
What do you mean?
The good relation with a good environment.
All right, yeah. All right. Mm. All right, very good. Based on respect, of course, right?
Open-minded.
Open-minded, all right, very good. Okay, very nice. What about life perspective?
Wow, it's like, it's a, how long do you think you're gonna live? I think so, I don't know.
No, that's life expectancy.
Expectancy,
yeah,
oh.
Perspective is like the way you see things, how people okay. In your workplace at SEPA, for example, how people view life in general, you know? What is the perspective?
Wow.
To be better always.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Okay. To keep on improving yourselves.
Yeah.
My right. Good environment.
Okay.
Benefits.
Quality. Be happy.
Happy. A good salary.
Yeah. Happiness. Good salary. Yeah. Happiness. Yes. Yeah. To be positive. I mean, do you guys like to work around people that are always negative?
No.
No.
So
it gets contagious. All right. Anything else about life perspective? How people see life?
Yes.
Do you guys think that a baby boomer life perspective is different from a millennial?
Sure.
Yeah. All right.
Yes. Because a baby boomer they had this idea to commit with life, mm-hmm. really young, to buy a house, to get married, to have children.
All right.
And I think that the millennials are like delaying those things.
All right.
For later in life.
Okay.
To buy a house to get married and those things.
Leave the parents' house.
They live in their parents' house.
Right. Yes.
But the baby boomers have a good environment with the family.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And have a own house.
Okay. Yeah. Right. Okay. Yeah, because they were like focused on that. As Diana was saying, maybe they were focusing on those things like at early ages than now, like millennials or like the earlier millennials, the later millennials, all right? They're not mm-hmm. really thinking about like family, for example, all right? Now you see a lot of people, they are 30, on their 30s and they're not married, all right? Before, I don't know if you guys, I mean, I think everybody has heard that. La va a dejar el tren, all right? Si ha llegado a los 30, ya la dejaba el tren. Y la gente se afligía, right? Now, not anymore, right? Now people are 30, 35, and they are not marrying yet. Or maybe they just got married and they have one child, all right? Before it was like, si a los 30 decían que era solterona y amargada, all right? So, but now that has changed, all right? Because now the people are, you know, in debt with their own self. All right, okay. Very good.
Just speaking about the last perspective, I believe some millennials are, how to say, self-centered.
Yeah.
Self-centered, sure. Like a hedonist.
Okay.
The hedonist, they look for pleasure.
Okay.
In all the dimensions, I mean the time. Travel a lot. Enjoy a lot. Just pleasure.
Right.
But it's not bad. I'm not against it.
As soon as it meddles
with the job and the objective.
Right. Yeah. Very good. Yes, Silvita. I mean, Vero, I think you were going to say something.
Yes, I read that nowadays the 30s are considered the new 20s.
Yeah. That's right. That's interesting. Very good. All right. What about perspective about time? What are the perspective of different generations about time?
I think all to take advantage of.
Okay.
Because we need to improve more and more.
Right. Okay. All right. Very good. All right. Now, do you think millennials worry a lot about today or tomorrow?
They think in the short terms.
Yeah. Right. Okay.
But at the same time, I think that millennial generation have a lot of troubles with anxiety.
Okay. Uh huh.
Because we have a lot of pressure about doing the things like really well.
All right. Okay. And very good.
I think that this generation have a lot of problems with that.
Okay.
Because
all right.
they are feeling like if they don't get the things really perfectly, they are like really anxious.
Right. Okay. Very good. What about the last one, productivity and efficiency? What do you guys think? Talking about different generations at the workplace. Productivity and efficiency.
Teacher?
Yes, Irene.
For me, the productivity and efficiency is depend on the generation. But if you plus each generation, you can have a better result.
Okay. All right.
Only that.
All right. Very good, Irene. Diana, you were going to say something?
Yes, I think that millennials are more focused on the results.
Right.
And baby boomers, they are and Gen X, they are like more focused on results too. Right. And baby boomers, they are like focused on the whole process.
Right. Okay. All right. Yeah, they're maybe more concentrated on processes. All right. Very good. All right, guys. I think we have reached the end. All right. It's 10 o'clock exactly on the dot. I do want to say thank you for being with me these whole 5 weeks. I know and I truly appreciate your time. All right. I know it's difficult because we all work and we are tired and we have many, many things to do. but you have committed to this challenge, all right, or this improvement, your own professional improvement, which is very, very good. I do admire that. All right, so I do want to say thank you. I hope that you guys keep on learning and keep on, you know, improving your. Remember that we never stop learning. All right, so that's a key. All right, so thank you so much. And I hope to see you around and I hope to see you later. All right. Yes. All right, guys.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher. I hope to see you in the next.
Thank you, teacher, for today. Yes. Before
thank you, Jesse. Yes. Yes.
See you in the next module. Yes, me too.
We'll see. All right. Yes, thank teacher. You. All right. Very good. See you all soon, guys. See you soon. Take care. La plataforma, okay? Acuérdese que tenemos hasta mañana tempranito.
I'm ¿sí? finished.
Así. Excellent, Jenny. Very good. ¿Quién más ya terminó?
I'm finished, teacher.
Excellent, Guillermo. Very good. Thank you, okay. Jesse. All right. Así que los demás, pónganse ya rapidito a hacer eso, okay? All right, guys. Bye-bye. Thank you. It was a pleasure thank to meet you. All right.
Good night.
Bye-bye. Good night.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Bye, a pleasure.
Bless you.
All right.
Bye.
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 Hi, Elita. Hola, Eli.
Hi, teacher. Ya se fueron todos.
Sí, no se preocupe, Eli. That's okay. Eli, ¿ya terminó la plataforma, Eli?
Sí, teacher. Fíjese okay. Que terminé, pero fíjese que en la segunda parte del midterm hay dos oraciones que no me salieron bien de ninguna forma.
¿El midterm o el final? Eli.
Hola.
¿El examen de medio, de medio curso o el examen final, Eli?
No, el medio. Del medio, es que siempre se me había olvidado decirle y ayer que terminé, vi que tenía 97.
¡Ay, Eli!
Y fui a ver, y fui a ver cuál era el error. Y eran esas dos oraciones de la segunda parte del meter.
Si gusta, cuando terminemos, ¿le ayudo con eso en el WhatsApp?
Vaya, sí. Ahí le voy a mandar la captura.
Vaya, ajá. Y me dice, midterm, ¿se acuerda la sección?
La segunda parte.
Ah, vaya. Ok.
Ajá.
Vaya, Eli, no sí. Se preocupe.
Se me fue la luz, teacher, por eso me sacó. Okay, y mire que esta computadora toda lenta y en el celular no tengo carga mucha y el Zoom se gasta la carga rápido.
Sí, cierto, sí se va rápida la carga. Vaya, Elita.
Y esta cosa cuando quiere me da la cámara y cuando no quiere no. Es que ya está muy viejita, teacher.
En serio. Mire, y esa yo vino por tu casa ya, Eli.
Tengo más de 5 años de tenerla. Hola.
Sí, está lloviendo por su casita, ¿no?
Sí, está lloviendo ahorita.
Ajá. Sí, aquí también acaba de empezar.
Y como esta cosa se apaga, porque si no está conectada, se apaga.
Ok.
Por eso, ah, teacher.
Qué bueno, Eli.
Gracias, teacher, por todo. Ya y saben. A saber cuándo vamos a comenzar, va.
Fíjese que no sé todavía de fechas, pero, pero es de estar pendiente ahí, Eli, oye.
Ojalá que me hayan mandado la documentación. Mañana le voy a hablar a la licenciada.
Vaya, sí. Y de todas maneras...
No, ya me la mandan del colegio.
Ajá. Estamos, ¿verdad? No pierdan mi número, Eli.
No, hombre, teacher. Y espero que sea nuestra teacher en el otro módulo también.
El otro, pues sí. Hay que seguir, Eli.
Sí, ahí vamos a estar primero, Dios.
Está bien.
Vaya, pues, teacher, vaya, mucho pues, gusto.
Feliz, igualmente, un abrazo, oye.
Igual, cuídese, cuídese. Si estamos cualquier duda con su niña, ya sabe.
Sí, gracias. Igual, gracias, Eli.
Vaya, teacher.
Cuídese, un abrazo.
Gracias.